Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I am back with another video, and this time we're going to be trying out the McCart Polygel kit. So as you can see, it comes with its own little UV light. This is a 24 watt UV LED lamp, and you can find these on Amazon. Again, it comes with the whole little kit, and then in the other little box it comes with the actual polygel, and then it even comes with some glitters, a base coat, a top coat, the nail forms, nail file, the little plastic forms, these forms, and then it also comes with the brush and the little spatula, and it comes with the pink polygel, white and clear as well. And then the glitters is just the blue, a silver, a pink, a blue. I think I already said blue, but it just comes with random little glitters. So the first thing that we're gonna be doing, I'm not gonna be prepping the nail or anything. Like in this video, I literally it was like a last minute thing. I was just like, oh, you know, like let me give polygel another try. So I just decided to do it. I did do a little bit of cuticle oil on my natural nail, that way I can take it off right after. But of course, whenever you're doing polygel, it's the same process as when you're doing acrylic nails, as far as like prepping the nail. So you would of course just as always pushing back the cuticles, removing the shine from the natural nail, and that's about it. And you can use these forms, or you could use the dual forms that it also comes with. So I'm gonna be doing a French tip, so like a reverse French nail. So I'm gonna use the pink first. So as you can see, you squeeze it out, get the spatula, and then just place the bead right on the nail. And then I'm gonna use the other side of the little brush, the actual brush, and I have a little dapping dish with alcohol, and you want to make sure that you keep dipping your brush into the alcohol to dab or pat the polygel, because if not, the product is gonna get stuck to your brush. And that's really one of the most important things that when you're doing polygel, is making sure that you keep your brush a little bit wet with the alcohol, because again, if not, it's going to be a hot mess. The product is going to get stuck to your brush, and if it does, just wipe your brush off and then dip it back into the alcohol and just keep patting the nail. So when you're doing polygel, it's not really much like brushing you have to do. It's mostly just patting the product where you want it to go. I did do just a little bit of brushing, but remember, you want to make sure that you keep your brush nice and wet when you're doing this. Not soaking wet, but you do want to make sure that it's not dry. Of course, you know, just like any other time, making sure that the product is not on the skin. And then I'm also trying to make sure that I have a nice free edge, because I am going to be filing it just a little bit before we go back in and do the white. So as you can see, I'm sitting there trying to shape up that smile line, and then after that I just go in there and just cure it for 60 seconds. After that, I'm gonna go ahead and do the other nail, the other finger. So for that one, I'm gonna use the clear polygel. So same thing, just put the polygel on the middle of the nail, and then this one I'm gonna do like into a coffin shape. So place the bead, and then again dip your brush into the alcohol, and then just start patting away. Now, one thing that I did like about the polygel is that it gives you an unlimited time to kind of play with it and move it around and shape it up and smooth it out, because it does not dry until you put it under the light. So that's really good for beginners. I know with acrylic, you know, you kind of have to work with it pretty fast, especially depending on what brand it is, because if not, it will dry up before you can smooth it out. But with this one, again, it does not dry until you put it under the light. So as you can see, I kind of just took my time to shape it up and smooth it out. And then with this one, I am going to be applying a little bit of glitter as well on the tip. And with that one, you can just apply the glitter, like just dip your brush into the glitter and just dab it on the nail, which is what I did. I also placed a few little pieces of gold foil on there, and then same thing, we have to come back in and encapsulate it. Now again, this is only my second time doing it, so honestly I feel like I did a lot better than I did the very first time, but this time I was just, you know, messing with it. I'm gonna go in and get another bead and place it closer to the back towards the cuticle area. And even with these, you know, you still have to make sure that you have that nice apex, that way the nails do not break off. But then before I brush the product all the way down towards the tip, I'm gonna go ahead and place the glitter. As you can see, it's just a really pretty blue glitter, just placing it on the tip, and then I'm gonna go in and place some little gold pieces on there as well. And then, as you can see, that bead of poly gel that we have sitting there, we're gonna just brush it all the way down towards the tip. More patting, and then afterwards we're going to come back in and apply a little bit more towards the tip. And then, as you can see, I'm really, really gentle when I'm doing this, especially around the cuticle area, just literally patting that area, making sure that it's nice and neat, cleaning around, making sure that we don't have any product on the skin. After that, we're going to care for another 60 seconds, and then I'm going to go in and go ahead and do another bead of that clear to make sure that the glitter is fully encapsulated, because as you guys seen the first bead that we did to encapsulate it, it was just the bead that was coming from that cuticle area, so we still did not have a nice thickness at the tip and some of that glitter was still sticking out. So I just had to go make sure that whenever I came back in to file, I wasn't going to file away any of that glitter. But again, you know, with this poly gel, you have an unlimited time to mess with it, to smooth it out. But remember, you want to make sure that when you're doing this, your brush is a little bit damp, that way you can work with the product really easily and it doesn't get stuck to your brush. And if it does, just clean your brush off, dip it into the alcohol, wipe it off on the paper towel, and you're ready to go. So this does leave a sticky layer, so I went ahead and wiped that off. And then now I'm gonna go ahead and shape up that middle finger, and I'm just creating a nice not necessarily a smile line, but since we are going to do the French tip, you want to make sure that you have that nice smile line or free edge. That way, whenever you apply the white, you know, you just have to apply it and you don't have to worry about cleaning up the smile line or anything. So this one is the white poly gel, so same thing, placing it on the spatula, just getting a bead and then placing it on the tip. And then we're gonna go ahead and start patting away and pushing it up towards the sides of the nails, like you see me doing here. And then, of course, you know, you can make it as long or short as you want, so just pat it, you know, push it up, and then make sure that you smooth it out. And then even with this one, if you get it on the pink, it doesn't matter, because once we come back in to file the nail, it's going to come off and then we'll have a really nice smile line. So yeah, I think that's pretty much, you know, everything there is to it. Just a lot of padding. But again, if you're a beginner, I really do like that you can, you know, you have an unlimited time to mess with it, to smooth it out, so you don't have to worry about it drying super fast, or you're not having enough time to you know, shape the nail, or whatever the case may be. So that's a really big plus. And again, this little kit I've had for so long, y'all, but I was just not a big fan of poly gel, and I think it was mostly because I hadn't really gave it a try. Like, I was just kind of like, oh, I can't do it, and just put it back down. But this kit was actually, you know, pretty nice, especially if you're a beginner. Again, it comes with a clear, a white, a pink, some glitters, forms, the other little dual forms, the brush, the spatula, and the nail file. So if you're looking for a little kit, you know, to just practice with or just to test out, this one would definitely be good. I don't really have many. I think I have one more poly gel kit. I think I actually have a video, so I'll be sure to look for it, to, you know, leave the link down below for you guys. But I don't really have any other brands to compare them to. I know I have one by Model Ones, but they're actually glitters and I wanted, you know, solid colors. So if I get a chance, I'll be sure to test that one out to see, you know, if there's a big difference. But again, I know the other one is all like glitter poly gels. But after we finish doing this, after we smooth out the white, we're gonna go ahead and put it under the light for another 60 seconds. And then again, you don't have to worry about that smile line being so perfect when you're doing this, because once we go back in to file the nail, you know, it will get filed away. So this is what it looks like. I'm putting it back under the light, and then once it's cured for 60 seconds, we're gonna go in there with the hand file and we can start shaping up the nail. So just like any time, we file the sides and the free edge at exactly a 90 degree angle, and also just filing the rest of the nail. I'm only using my hand file, so I'm also gonna use that to file around the cuticle area. But remember, I'm not keeping these nails on, so make sure that if you are keeping a full set of poly gels, that of course you prep the nail as far as pushing back the cuticles, removing the shine, and making sure, I don't know if you actually need a primer for this. Let me know down below if you've used PolyGel. Do you have to use a primer? Like, I know it didn't come with one, but I don't know if that's something that you have to use. Again, I'm not really experienced with PolyGel. I've given it, this is my second try, and it was definitely a lot better than the first time. So just let me know down below if you need a primer when you're using PolyGel. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and shape up the other nail as well. We're doing a coffin shape, so same thing, 90 degree angle on the sides and the fridge, and putting a little bit more of that pressure towards the tip since we want it to be more narrow. Alrighty, so now we're just going in and buffing the nails, and this is going to get rid of any of the scratches left on the nail from the hand file. And y'all, that middle finger is so pretty to me. Like, I literally been wanting a set with just all French tip nails, just like this one, but of course long and coffin. But it's just hard for me to do my right hand with my left hand, but I would definitely love to get something like that done really soon. But anyways, afterwards we just dust the nails off, wipe them off with an alcohol wipe, and then I'm gonna go in with the top coat. Now, it also came with a base, so I know for a fact that you would have to apply the base and then go in with the PolyGel, but again, I did skip that step because I'm gonna take these nails off right after. So if you just want to practice, you know, you don't want to leave the nails on, I would suggest doing what I did and just doing a little bit of cuticle oil on your nail bed. That way the PolyGel doesn't really adhere to the nail. And same thing, if you ever want to practice acrylic, just add a little bit of cuticle oil on your nail bed and just it'll come right off. But as you can see, it came with a little template with instructions on how to apply the PolyGel with the forms, with the dual forms and the glitter as well. So I really like that as well. But then now I'm just going in and applying some bling. So I'm using my ABS S6 SS12 and I'm applying that with my wax pencil. Alrighty y'all, so that is really it for this video. As you can see, they turned out really pretty. I love that French tip that I did. I was actually amazed at how good I was able to make it look. And then of course the other one is really pretty as well with the glitter. So as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at GetNail32, and I'll see you guys next time.